So when you put the new pads in, you have to put this sleeve back in, holding it with your hand, and you have to put this mounting bolt into. When you put this mounting bolt, you will need to secure him with a clamp on the other side. So you have to put the bolt. This is the most important thing. It has to realign there properly. Use the flat screwdriver. Yes, this is the way how it's supposed to be. So, we figured out how properly to install it. You have to put the sleeve. You have to hold the sleeve with your hand. You have to put the bolt inside. And when the bolt is inside, you have to use the flat screwdriver. And you have to put it, this little piece on top of the caliper. This is the way how you will properly secure the sleeve. So your brake pads not gonna fall off while driving. The next step, you have to put this little clamp to secure the bolt. This little piece. You have to install him here. So you have to put this little piece back in. Double check everything. And then mount these bolts to spec. These two bolts that we removed to remove the whole assembly. The caliper piston assembly. Just tighten them. Make sure that they tighten the pegs, because you don't want while driving to remove the caliper piston. And one more time, you're not gonna be able to replace the brake pads without removing the assembly, because you're not gonna be able to compress the caliper piston. Last step that is need to be to performed, you just need to put the tire back on and make some drive test to make sure that you installed everything properly. After the first set is successfully done, I will demonstrate in more details how you can do the second part of the rear brakes. So this is replacement of the rear brake pads on the second on the driver side. The first one was on the passenger side. This is the front side. First of all, you put up the vehicle up, then you remove the tire. So remove the tire. So as I mentioned before, you're not gonna be able to compress the caliper piston back in if you're not gonna remove those two bolts. You need completely to remove the assembly. This bolt and one bolt in the bottom. Use the brake bar to remove it. So after the bolt is loose, using the brake bar, use the ratchet. Removing the bolt on the bottom. After the bolt in the bottom is removed, proceed to remove the bolt on top. This one. They're pretty stubborn. You can try to use ratchet at the beginning, but I think that you will be unsuccessful. As you can see, it's almost impossible. Because you obviously need a brake bar. It gives you approximately 50% more resistance. You see? It was simple as that. After you made it loose a little bit, just remove it and put it on the ratchet. And then finish it with the ratchet.
Just simple like that. When it's already too loose, you don't need even a ratchet, just use your hands.
Remove the assembly. So the next step that need to be performed by you, you have to remove this little pin. The pin that is mounted there is removed. Then using like maybe a small mallet, or you just need to hit a little bit this piston that is mounted in the sleeve. If you are unsuccessful, just use something small. This something small need directly to hit on it.
Or a screwdriver.